Hi, hello friends. Welcome back to High Tech Institution video series. So today we are going to discuss about AWS Organization Service. Okay. So this is one of the default service which is there in AWS. But the thing is, now people are started using AWS Organization more and more. Okay. So that is the reason we took this topic for today's discussion. So this is our website. If you wanted to know more detail about us, please browse through this hightechins.in. So let me move on to the AWS Organization Service. So see guys, we are majorly focusing on AWS Organization Service when in any organization they are using multiple AWS accounts. Okay, in terms of handling so many root accounts, okay, so many AWS root accounts, it'll be pretty much difficult in terms of billing, in terms of remembering all the usernames and password, and in terms of applying a policies and restricting it. So it is pretty much complex. Okay, that is the reason AWS has been introduced. AWS Organizations is one of the service. Through this service, we can centrally manage multiple AWS services. Okay, I mean multiple AWS accounts. See, I'll tell you, we have multiple accounts. Consider like this. This is one of my AWS accounts. This is one of my AWS accounts. These are different root accounts. Okay, this account has been created for the production purpose, or we'll tell this is for sandbox. Okay, this is for production. This is for testing. So this is for any VPN or any particular on-premises connectivity. Or this is for any database or application, anything like that. Okay, just consider this are different examples. I'm managing multiple AWS accounts for different purposes. Each account has their own root credentials. Okay, the problem here is currently what we are facing. We'll not be able to remember all the username and password of every accounts. And managing the permissions and managing the billings, this and all will be consuming more and more time. It will make us complex. Even as of now, I mentioned 5 accounts. Let's assume in any organization, they are maintaining 50 accounts, 100 AWS account. In that case, it will be very much complex. So in order to avoid this problem only, what people has done is they started using AWS Organization Service. This AWS Organization Service, how this is organized, how the architecture going to be like. Initially, we'll be having one AWS account. This is considered as a payroot account. Okay, you have to understand this is AWS payroot account. Let me reduce the font size so it will be easy to use. Okay, this account is considered as a AWS payroot account. So where this kind of a master account. Okay. So see, master account, I already logged in with my multiple AWS accounts. See, currently we are using this account, right? This particular account going to be my master. So let me open account properties. So over here, so if you see, right? So this is my account ID. This is going to be my master account. Okay, this will be my master account. So which master account which I opened in Firefox. Okay, so also I'll be having another slave account which I logged in my Chrome browser. Okay, because at a time we'll not be able to open this account in same browser, so that is why I'm using two different browsers. So similar way, in this example I'm going to tell you adding one or two AWS accounts. Feature similar way only. If you understand adding single account, similar way you have to add remaining accounts and managing these things and all. Fine. So this particular account ID going to be like DevOps, which I opened in Firefox, which going to act as my AWS account. Okay, this is a normal AWS account. Considered, this is my AWS account. Okay. Now what I'm going to do? I'm going to link up this with organizations. Make sense? So we'll use different colors so it'll more attractive. Okay, fine. So all right. So this is my one of my AWS account. This is another my root account. Similar way, if you have a multiple AWS accounts, right? You have what you have to do? You have to connect the thing like this. Okay. Okay. So at the end, what you will do will be connecting this with your payroot. Got it? but everyone will not be having a same account ID. Probably account ID will be getting changing often based on this. Got it? The actual thing. The actual thing, this is my particular account which we are going to take this as example today. Okay, so if you understand how we are adding this account, how we are enabling this pay route, okay, and how we are adding this account with pay route. So if you once you understand this, remaining adding addition of remaining accounts also somewhat similar like this. Okay, so in AWS organization service, initially we are going to build up the AWS pay route. Okay, this pay route account we need to enable. After that only we'll be calling remaining accounts to be part of this pay route account. Once if you set up this architecture like this, for managing billing for all remaining accounts can be done through this pay route account. So even if you have 50 accounts or 100 accounts, billing can be managed from this pay route account. That is one of advantage. And second advantage, you can restrict giving a policy from my pay root account. Okay, it's somewhat similar like our Windows Active Directory. I don't know whether how many of you are aware about Microsoft Active Directory service, how it will be having root domain controller, child domain controller. It's somewhat similar to that. Okay, the concept is exact similar. From your pay root account, you'll be able to giving a policies, you'll be able to managing this policy, that and all telling us a SCP policies we'll be discussing at the end of this video. So probably like this pay root account has few advantages, which are billings are centralized, account billings need not to pay again and again, and policies can be applied from pay root. So we need not to apply a policy for every account. Okay, so fine. And once we are being part of this account, right, everything will be even this account will have a root account, root credential, right? Every account will be having root credential. We know root account will have a full privilege of owning this entire AWS account, but if you're being part of this AWS pay root, that root will not get a full privilege. Even we can restrict the root user also. Okay, if a restrict user has to do this thing, we can restrict the root user has to do these things. Similar way, we can restrict it. So that is another advantage. Even we can restrict the root user. It will be somewhat like, see, there are many advantages are there. If I start writing now, it will keeps going on. So fine, while discussing the topic, we'll see. Okay, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to log into this master account. I'm going to AWS organization service. I'm going to make this as a pay root account. Okay, I'll be doing it. So we are logged in using this, right? So let me move on to my AWS console, in the sense home page. If you go there under management and governance, you'll be getting AWS organizations. Okay, you need to select from here. Once you selected, right, initially in this account I already enabled it, AWS organization. That is why you are getting like this. So initially when you are trying from your end, no, so it will be, you'll be getting it like somewhat similar to this. For the very first time I'm telling, okay, you'll be getting it like this only. You need to create organizations, so which I have already created over here. Okay, that is why I'm directly getting into it. For remaining account, when you are trying to create any pay root account, it will be looking like this only. Okay, so see, this account, this is another account. We are not going to make this as a pay root account. If you want to make any account as a pay root, you need to click on create organization. So it will be started looking like this. So what's looking like this. Okay, so as of now, this color arrow, this particular account, right, this particular account we are making as a root. Okay, that is why we are getting star here. This is a master account, this is a pay root account. In terms of adding another account, right, I am going to use this particular account. This particular account going to be the what, my secondary account. See, this is my parent account, this is my secondary account. This account I opened in Firefox, this account I opened in Chrome. So from this account I'm going to log in. I'm going to add account. I'm going to click add account. In terms of adding accounts to your payroll, we need to click on add accounts. You'll be getting these two options. One is invite account, another one is create account. Okay. One is invite account, another one is create account. If you see invite account in the sense, there are pre-exist account is there. You can go ahead and invite them. See, this is pre-exist AWS account, which is standalone. It's not being part of any AWS organizations. So that account, we can invite them and we can add them into part of this root pay. Okay. So we'll discuss what does mean by create account. Okay. Now I'm going to tell about invite account. I'm click on invite. So it is asking for the account ID or email ID, anything we need to provide. So now I'm going to give my email, email ID of this particular account. Okay. Fine. Surya. Okay, so this is going to be the email ID. So let me put on some notes. This is optional. Request to join with high tech organizations. Okay, some you can put out some notes and you can send the invite. Okay, now I'm going to send the invite. So see, invite has been opened. So before starting recording, no, I was just tried out it. Because it should not throw some error, right? That is why it's showing us approved. As of now, when you are trying, this will not be there. Okay, I just removed that account. You'll be getting this point only. Okay, see, the status is open. So now I'm moving on to my account here. I send the invite. No, it will be came to this particular email ID. Okay, same email ID. surya995@gmail.com. So it's came. So what you need to do is solve the thing from this particular account. This is the owner. This account is giving an invite. So what you need to do, you need to click on this link. See, you got the invite from so here, invitation for joining other organizations, please respond. So this is the master account name. This is request to join. We gave the notes, right? Everything came here. Okay, so on click on accept. So confirm. So once you confirm, row, so this account is being started being part of payroll account. See, it's become part of your account is belongs to the following organizations, kalayaro@gmail.com. Okay, this is how we'll be adding our existing account to our AWS organization. So now I'm going to tell you how we are going to manage it. So now let me switch back to my payroll account. Okay, if you go for accounts, I'll be able to see DevOps this account, because earlier this account were not there, right? We are only seeing Kalai. So now this account has been joined. See, the joined date also is current date. Okay, if we go for organize accounts, here you can create multiple OUs and you can manage it. What does mean by OUs? See, again back to this diagram, there is another concept called OU. We can tell this is another example, another advantage. OU in the sense, we have a master payroll account, right? We have a master payroll account. From there, what we can do, we can divide this as multiple OUs. So you can create a OU like this. Organization units. OU in this an organization. This is pay root. Organization unit. I just understand this is for productions. This is for testing. This is for networking. Okay, we'll be creating organization unit like this. And whatever the account is, there are no sub accounts. You can add them into the OUs. So here, if you apply any policies to OU, it will be applicable to the entire account who are being part of that OU. Okay, this is all considered as a OU. This is considered as OU. OU is an organization unit. Okay, Make sense? So the small stars are individual AWS accounts. Fine. So now what I'm going to do, in my accounts I could see there are many accounts are there. If you go to the organize accounts, right? So as of now we have two accounts, which is master, another one is my secondary account. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a new organization unit. I'm click on create new organization unit. I'm going to give the name like production account. I'm going to map with this. Okay, I'm going to create another one that is for sandbox or testing, whatever. Okay, I'm going to create another account. So now in terms of moving any accounts to any organization unit, what you need to do, you need to click on this checkbox. You'll be getting option like move. Click on move. It'll be giving you whatever the organization unit available. So now I'm going to move this account into production. So I'm clicking on move. See, this account is moved to production. So if you are dragging this out, you'll be able to see the, sorry, if you're clicking this, you'll be able to see the account. Until unless you'll not be able to see this account. Okay. Similar way only, you'll be creating organization unit and mapping the organization unit, accounts to concern organization units. Okay, whenever you are adding any new account, it will be being part of this open. I mean, it will be available under root. You need to associate with the corresponding organizations unit. Okay, fine. All right. Now, what I am going to tell you is, then next we'll discuss about the policies. Okay. So in the policies, if I click on policies, there will be default policies which is available already. We can create new policies also. This policy is calling it as the SCP policies. Okay. So see, I have taken this website for giving you the examples for SCP policies. So service control policies. What we can do through the service control policies? SCP policies can be created in payroot. Okay. SCP policies can be created in payroot. This SCP policies can be associated with the OUs. This SCP policies can be associated with any one of this OU. If you are associated with this OU, whatever the account is mapped with this OU, those account will be take effect by this policy. Okay. We'll see what is meant by SCP and how to create a policies and all. And I'll be mapping it with concern organization unit. Okay. So I'm back to it. So if you browse through there, this is Amazon default account. Okay. So fine. In this AWS documentation, you'll be able to see multiple examples for SCP policies. So you need not to search anywhere. Almost maximum of things, they have provided it already. Okay. So now I'm going to tell few more examples. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a policy. What this policy is going to do, from this payroot, I'm going to create a policy. This policy is going to do like restriction on roles. Okay, IAM roles. IAM roles restrictions. Okay, so I'm going to restrict, you cannot delete any roles, you cannot update any roles, you cannot modify anything in IAM roles. Okay, those kind of restrictions I'm going to give. This policy also, we have a two way of doing. One is graphically we can do. Another one is through JSON, SQL AWS policies we can do. Okay, one is option they have given for GUI. And another one way of doing this is for JSON. Normal AWS policies, same kind of method. Okay, so we'll see what are the difference of both. So I'm back to my AWS account. So if you go on create new policy, so it'll ask you to enter the name of the policy. Clicking on create policy. So it is asking you to enter the name of the policy. Now I'm going to work with IAM. So IAM roles, I can mention like IAM roles. So description, whatever you want to give, you can give it. So if you see, I'll tell you how we'll be creating policy graphically. If you see, there are almost all the services that they have listed out here. If you want to work with any service, right, you can type EC2 means EC2 will come. IAM means IAM will come. The concern service will come. You can click on IAM. So add a user to group, change password, whatever. If you have something related to roles, right, you can mention and pick it like a role. It's not coming. No user from group. Okay, So fine, you have to check one by one. May sometime the naming convention might be not as our English word, okay? So you need to check it out here. So if you go there, you need to pick on detach role policy. See, something here. Effect, you will be doing two things. One is allow, another one is deny. If you are doing deny, detach policy from any resources, right? It will not work. So if you go there to add resource, if you want to do any with, if you are going to apply this policy with particular role, you can add that role here. See, IAM roles. We need to add it like particular role ARN we need to give. Otherwise, all resource mean it will take the that as a star. So see, it is coming. Double quote star means it is applicable to entire roles. Okay, fine. So this is the way of doing graphically the policies, and I kept many examples here. So this is a policy which is for denying attach. You cannot attach any policy. You cannot delete the role. You cannot delete the permissions. You cannot delete the role policy. So the roles are something like this. So see, but they are asking us to specify the ARN in terms of applying to any all the services in this place. We need to give star. So I'm copying this now. I'm moving back to this. So I'm adding it here. So here only there is some small correction which need to be star. Okay, so before that, this policy I'm going to apply to this particular account. Okay, so I'm going to this account. I'll just open IAM, because right now we need to check, right, before applying this policy whether it's working or not. After that, we'll apply the policy. Let's check whether the restriction is working properly or not. So I'm going to the role. So here, if you create any role, test SCP role. Okay, I'm going to create a role like this. Fine. So in terms of doing any policy attach or whatever, deleting also, this will get delete. So but I'm going to attach the policy now. See, we are given the script. So I'm going to create a policy now. Policy is creating. Okay, policy has been created. Now how to attach this policy with the organization unit? In terms of attaching this policy with the organization, you need to go there. You need to click on particular organization unit. So there you will be getting options for service control policy, SCP policy. You need to click on here. So you need to attach this. Whatever the policy you will have, it will be displaying here. So you need to click on attach. So this policy is mapped with this OU. If you go through the sandbox, no, this will not be attached with this. Here it will be still open only. See, it is not detached. I mean attached. They're asking us to attach. It's not required. This policy is, we are predominantly created for the production OU. So that is why we attached it. So we have attached it, right? So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to this account. I'm going to check by deleting this role or adding something and modifying some changes to this role. Let's see, because I logged in with the root account. Okay, initially we were discussing, even if you applied any policy, root will not be able to do it. That is, we mentioned that as a advantage also, right? So let's check. I'm going to delete this. So I'm selected the policy. I'm going to delete role now. When I click on delete, it should give me an error. See, even I logged in with the root account, it was giving me an error. Why? Because this particular user is not authorized to perform a role, because this has been explicitly denied. See why? Because we have denied from this OU, right? By giving this SCP policies. So similar way, you can make use of this documentation. There are plenty of examples they have given. Even if you search more, no, internet, you will be getting many things. Even if you're unable to do it, you can do it through graphically also. You'll be able to make up policies. That is another advantage of AWS organizations. So this is what we are planning to discuss today. And if you want to leave this organization, what you need to do? So that will keep that as a later part. So now I'm going to detach this policy. Okay, once we detach, let's see whether that IAM role can be deleted or not. Okay, I'm going to delete this IAM role now, because policy has been detached, right? Let me give one delete. Still, it's giving me error. I think policy is not yet applied. Let's refresh one more time. We'll after refresh, we'll try once again. Okay, this has been deleted now. So after denying the, I mean after removing the policy. Okay, so this is what guys, what we plan today. AWS Organization Service from Payroot, whatever you think, you can do it. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. And if you like this, our channel, our videos, everything, please subscribe our channel and do share with your friends. So daily basis, we'll be uploading our technical videos, which is related to cloud and DevOps. Okay, thanks for watching this video. If you need any other further more detail, you can also get it from our website. Okay, you'll be getting contact number, everything from here. Thank you. Thanks for watching this video.